It's a real pleasure to welcome to Athens my fellow heads of state and government for what is officially the first Med9 meeting with the addition of Slovenia and Croatia. I'm also particularly happy that on the agenda we will have the issue of the climate crisis that the Mediterranean is facing today. We will have the opportunity to adopt the Athens Declaration, which sets out the Mediterranean, the priorities of the Mediterranean and southern countries in addressing the climate crisis, which particularly affects our common sea, the Mediterranean. We will also have an opportunity to discuss other important geopolitical issues ranging from Afghanistan to the COVID pandemic. And of course, it will be a chance to reaffirm our commitment towards the important targets that we have set by the middle of the century to turn Europe into the first climate neutral continent. So I do hope that we will have a very, very productive meetings, and I'm happy that we were able to expand the scope of the Med7 to also include our friends from Slovenia and Croatia.
I'm extremely happy to be here at this summit, and even our short meeting with the Prime Minister was a good occasion to establish an enhanced way of doing things together, working together, cooperate more and more so. Thank you.
Bueno, buenos días. En primer lugar, agradecer a la hospitalidad del primer ministro griego y de todo el gobierno, la sociedad griega, por celebrar esta importante cumbre de todos los países del Mediterráneo. Damos también la bienvenida a Eslovenia y a Croacia en este Med7, que pasa a ser Med9, y también a la presidencia de la Comisión, que participa por primera vez en este importante encuentro. Estamos atravesando un momento de mucha más esperanza del que teníamos hace un año. Estamos superando la COVID, la economía europea se está recuperando con una fortaleza que incluso ha sorprendido las más optimistas previsiones, y lo que tenemos que hacer es poner en marcha todos los fondos europeos. España está apostando por la recuperación económica justa. Eso significa no solamente abordar la transición ecológica, la transformación digital, sino también dar una perspectiva de inclusión, de inclusividad social, territorial, de género y también intergeneracional a estos dos importantes vectores de la recuperación económica. Y en ese sentido yo quisiera también celebrar y apelando también al pilar social que se aprobó en la cumbre de Oporto el semestre pasado, quiero también celebrar el que el Gobierno de España haya logrado un acuerdo con los sindicatos para continuar en la senda de aumento del salario mínimo interprofesional para poder llegar a ese 60% marcado por la Carta de Derechos Sociales Europeo, a ese 60% de salario medio que represente al final de la legislatura el salario mínimo interprofesional. Gracias.
I would like to thank my friend Kyriakos Mitsotakis for inviting me for the first time to the Med9 summit, the EU members from the Mediterranean, and this is really a great new political message to the friendship between Greece and Croatia, and also Greece and Slovenia, because Slovenia and Croatia are here for the first time. A great opportunity for us to emancipate our Mediterranean and Adriatic identity, and an opportunity to give our own contribution to the key topics, which is of course the climate change that concerns us all, other economic and political issues which are on the agenda of consultations today, as well as certainly the security concerns that we are all globally faced with, especially with the consequences of the post-Afghanistan situation. So I'm very happy to be here again in Athens and grateful for the very substantive bilateral talks that I had this morning with Prime Minister Mitsotakis.
Καταρχήν θα ήθελα να ευχαριστήσω θερμά, αλλά και να συγχαρώ την ίδια ώρα τον φίλο Πρωθυπουργό της Ελλάδας Κυριάκο για την φιλοξενία αλλά και την άριστη διοργάνωση της παρούσας συνόδου. Μια συνόδου που υποδέχεται άλλα δύο μέλη, την Κροατία και τη Σλοβενία, δημιουργώντας κατά αυτόν τον τρόπο ένα φόρουμ που εκφράζει τα προβλήματα της Νότιας Ευρώπης και που σίγουρα επηρεάζουν τις πολιτικές της Ευρωπαϊκής Ένωσης. Κατά τη διάρκεια της συνόδου, όπως καλά γνωρίζετε, θα μας απασχολήσουν ζωτική σημασία θέματα, όπως είναι η κλιματική αλλαγή, τα όσα συμβαίνουν και επηρεάζουν την ειρήνη και τη σταθερότητα τόσο στην Ανατολική Μεσόγειο όσο και γενικότερα στην ευρύτερη περιοχή, όπως είναι τα προβλήματα που δημιουργούνται με το Αφγανιστάν, τη Συρία, τη Λιβύη και σωρία άλλων χωρών. Ενώ ταυτόχρονα θα έχω βεβαίως την ευκαιρία να ενημερώσω τους ομολόγους μου και για το παρόν στάδιο των όσων συμβαίνουν και αφορούν το κυπριακό πρόβλημα. Θέλω για άλλη μια φορά να ευχαριστήσω και να συγχαρώ τον φίλο Πρωθυπουργό. Ευχαριστώ πολύ.
It's an absolute pleasure to be here today with Prime Minister Mitsotakis and other colleagues. Many important items on today's agenda, two of which stand out. The handling of the pandemic. I believe that now the focus will keep on shifting towards the economic recovery part, obviously whilst always keeping an eye on the health part. The second, and perhaps the most important item on the agenda will be that of climate change. The biggest challenge, in my humble opinion, which we have in front of us, perhaps even greater than the handling of the pandemic itself. But there we made a very conscious choice. We're going to act together. And once we chose to act together, I am very positive that we will succeed even in this great challenge which we have before us.
I'm very pleased to be here representing Portugal in this summit of the Southern European countries. It's an informal group, but a very important one, and we shall discuss very important issues this afternoon and this evening. And I would point out the importance of the summit on the climate change and also several issues of external policy of the European Union that we will consider together. It is a very, very important meeting among the Southern European countries. Thank you.
So good afternoon. This is first time Slovenia is participating at the summit of the Mediterranean countries. It's a great honor for us to be invited. And we are looking forward to future cooperation. And this is especially good opportunity for us because Slovenia is now holding the rotating presidency of the Council of the European Union, and this is good opportunity, good occasion to discuss the urgent matters we are trying to solve on the European level. Thank you.
I very much applaud Prime Minister Mitsotakis for convening this EU Met summit here. It is absolutely the right move at the right time, because we all see that climate change is heavily affecting the Mediterranean region, and we need to find solution, and we can offer solution. So the discussion is about restoration after the horrifying wildfires and the stark rain and the flooding, but it is also about adaptation, for example, the procurement of more firefighter planes on a European level, and the most important part is the mitigation, that we are able to deal with climate change, and that is what the European Green Deal is all about. So we will discuss all the opportunities that the European Green Deal gives to fight climate change and therefore create a better future for the Mediterranean region.